Leaky gut syndrome is very common, yet a lot of people simply don't understand what it is and what the causes are. So today I'm going to tell you what is really behind leaky gut. I'm going to talk about some of the things that cause leaky gut, but also some of the things that you haven't heard about leaky gut syndrome, like your marriage or who you live with could be affecting your gut. If you're new to my channel, welcome. I'm Dr. Janine Bowring, naturopathic doctor, and let's get right into it. So what's really behind leaky gut? Well, the dietary causes of leaky gut syndrome are probably a top of the list. And one of the big culprits is polyunsaturated fatty acids, or PUFAs. And these are the omega-6s, which we tend to get so much more of as compared to the omega-3s in our diet. So it's really important that we are watching our intake of these inflammatory omega-6s. So whether it's the soy oil, it could be safflower oil, canola oil, margarine as well. These cause a lot of problems and inflammation in the gut lining. So if you're having a lot of these different types of oils in your diet, it's something that you really need to be aware of, especially if it's in already processed or baked goods. Again, this would be one of those hidden places that you could be ingesting some of these unhealthy oils and can be causing your leaky gut. Another problem is not having enough fiber in the diet. So ensuring that there's enough fiber is really important for making sure that we are preventing leaky gut syndrome. Another big one is artificial sweeteners and artificial sugars. So if you love to have your diet sodas, this is a problem because it can be related to that leaky gut and causing those problems with those tight junctions in the gut, which is something that I've talked about in another episode of the Dr. Janine Show. Also, dairy products, they can be very inflammatory as well and cause issues with the leaky gut, as well as wheat. So wheat products, if you're overdoing it, I'm not saying that you can never have them, but if you're overdoing it, then that would be a problem. So whether that's the breads, that's the baked goods, anytime that you're using a regular wheat flour, this could be having an impact on that leaky gut. Now, caffeine, if you're overdoing it with having too much caffeine, so I'm not saying one or two coffees or caffeine drinks or sources per day, that's okay, a little bit is okay, but overdoing it in terms of your caffeine could be having a negative impact and causing that leaky gut syndrome. The same is true for alcohol. So again, in moderation, it's okay, but if you're overindulging with alcohol, this can have a negative effect on those tight junctions in the gut and can be causing that dysbiosis and that leaky gut syndrome. Now, when we get to pharmaceuticals, so certain drugs can cause that leaky gut syndrome. So antibiotics, as well as aspirin and NSAIDs, so those painkillers, ibuprofen as well, and proton pump inhibitors. And here's the huge paradox, which is crazy to me, that you're taking something for your acid reflux, for your GERD. So, and what unfortunately those drugs are doing is that they are having more of an impact on the leaky gut syndrome in a negative way, and that causes more of the symptoms of having that acid reflux. So again, it's important to always do things naturally whenever you can in terms of your leaky gut. So continuing on, what else is really behind leaky gut? Well, it could be heavy metal toxicity. And this is something that I think of a patient that I had years ago, and I asked her, because she had so many symptoms of leaky gut, and I asked about heavy metal toxicity, if she had had any kind of exposure to heavy metals like mercury, aluminum. And she said that, oh yeah, I remember as a kid that she actually broke and was playing with the mercury in a thermometer. And I said, yeah, that could have been your exposure because of the toxicity element of these heavy metals. That could have been a causative factor for the leaky gut syndrome, as well as lack of vitamin C. And vitamin C, along with its bioflavonoids, that could be an indicator of the leaky gut syndrome, because now the collagen matrix is not as strong as what it should be in the gut wall. And that could be one of the causative factors as well. Stress, we know, always is correlated with digestive issues, but can be a causative factor for the leaky gut syndrome as well as brain injuries. So I want you to check out my show if you've not yet seen it, Depression. You're not depressed, it's in your gut. check out that episode. But even if there is that correlation we know between the brain and the gut-brain axis, as it's called, if you've had a brain injury, so whether that's a hematoma, you've had, you know, a concussion, that can definitely now have a negative impact on the functioning of your gut and can be a causative factor for leaky gut syndrome. As well as strenuous exercise. So imagine this, you are doing your best, you're trying to get healthy, or you've been healthy and you're overdoing it in terms of your exercise. If you're too rigorous with your exercise, this could be one of the causative factors for leaky gut as well. Infections as well, so candida, dysbiosis, and having that leaky gut syndrome can be related to some of these unhealthy organisms. H. pylori is another one that is notorious for causing those negative impacts on the tight junctions in the gut. And this is something that was discovered by Barry Marshall in terms of H. pylori being a causative agent, a bacteria that actually causes stomach ulcers. And the way he discovered it was by drinking a whole vial of the H. pylori bacteria, made himself sick, but then was able to cure it with antibiotics by killing off that bad bacteria. So yes, this is, you know, again, a causative factor perhaps of the leaky gut syndrome, and parasites as well. So if you've seen my other episodes when I talk about parasitic infections, how they can have that negative impact, again, on those tight junctions in the gut and really wreak havoc on your digestion. Now, nutrient deficiencies can also be a causative factor for leaky gut syndrome. So it's something that you want to definitely make sure that you're taking care of in terms of covering all your bases for the nutrients and the minerals that you need every single day. And another cause of leaky gut syndrome may be circadian rhythm mismatches. So if you're not following what Mother Nature intended us to do with our light and dark cycles of the day, this can be offsetting the way that your gut is supposed to digest and when it's supposed to digest its food. Now, EMF exposure is something that you've heard me talk about. So if you've not yet seen that episode, make sure you check out my other video, Secrets of How EMFs Affect Our Health. We have both part one and part two, but EMF exposure from our electronic devices definitely has a negative impact on our gut and can be one of the causative factors of the leaky gut syndrome. Now, it's interesting that children that have not been breastfed, so if they did not get that initial colostrum from their mothers, that this could be another reason for the leaky gut syndrome. And marriage. So this study actually shows that who you're married with and the feelings that you share in a marriage, either positive or negative, has an impact on the gut function and, you know, the parallel changes in gut microbiomes in terms of who you are married to definitely is a proven fact. So you've got good gut flora, good marriage. Hopefully that's what's happening for you. Not so good marriage, maybe not so good gut flora, and could be a causative factor for the leaky gut syndrome. So food for thought. So if you've got questions or comments about this video, please leave them below. I would love to hear from you. Also, be sure to share this video with someone that you may think finds that information very interesting. Please give me a big thumbs up. Be sure to subscribe if you're new here, and also click that bell for notifications. And remember to always take care of your good health and to do it naturally. Thanks for joining me today.